Today, I want to share with you a little bit of my personal story about how I transitioned 100% online, how I transitioned my training business 100% online. And it didn't happen overnight. So back in 2016, my husband and I, we closed our training gym. We closed our training gym so that my husband could accept a position with Cirque du Soleil and so that we could move out to Las Vegas. When I first moved out to Las Vegas in 2017, I wanted to transition my business 100% online. Now, I have been in the online space since 2012. I started out with a written blog when people used to actually write blogs and read blogs, which that doesn't happen so much anymore. So in 2012, I started out in the online space and I started training people online in 2013. At that time, I was using video conferencing like FaceTime, and I was using Excel spreadsheets. So that's what I was doing in 2013. And I always had a small online business with one-on-one clients and some single sale purchase programs. And then of course, with my women's strength workshop, I'm Not Afraid to Lift. And that started in 2014. So all of those things I balanced with the training gym that my husband and I owned back in Boston when we had our training gym from 2011 to 2016. So when we shut the business down and we moved out to Las Vegas, my goal was like, hey, I'm gonna be 100% online. That's what I'm gonna be doing in 2017. Although it didn't work out like that. We moved out here and in 2017, I was completely burnt out. I was completely fried. I was fried from running our gym plus traveling to teach my workshop, I'm Not Afraid to Lift, in addition to traveling to speak at other events such as Perform Better, Fitness Revolution Nation, Mark Fisher Fitness Lab. I even traveled to Australia for my Lift workshop. So running my business at home and then also having to travel. And I had a small online business. I had online training clients. I was balancing so much. I was completely fried by the end of 2016 from doing all that. So for me to think that I was going to be running all of a sudden, put all this effort into transitioning my business to 100% online in 2017, that really wasn't very realistic. In addition, I was completely burnt out from closing our business. That was a very stressful event to shut down a business and to notify clients that that's what you're going to be doing and just go through the process of shutting down a business. That was extremely stressful. I was also very stressed and burnt out after having to pack up our condo. My husband moved out to Las Vegas before me. I was completely by myself in Boston for 3 months. I had to pack up our condo, coordinate with the movers, get everything going. I had to do that. And then I drove cross country by myself to Las Vegas. And then I arrived in Las Vegas in January 2017. And let's also note that I had never visited Las Vegas ever in my entire life before I moved here. So then in January 2017, I arrived here and I'm thinking, oh yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and transition my business 100% online. I'm not gonna do anything else. That wasn't very realistic. And here's why. I needed to take care of myself. I needed to take care of me. I needed to rebuild myself. I was burnt out, I was stressed out. I also had lost a large part of my identity when we closed our business. And there are no business problems, there are only personal problems. So until you work on yourself and get yourself strong from within, and you get yourself into a good place, what's going to happen is those personal problems are going to manifest themselves in your business. So I spent all of 2017 rebuilding my energy, rebuilding myself. I read a lot of self-help books that year. And then I also explored other opportunities for me to make a part-time income. So that's when I applied for a job at Cirque du Soleil. I got the position to work part-time for Cirque du Soleil, and then I was assigned the show Ka. So I did that, and then slowly, little by little that year, I started to rebuild myself, and I started to rebuild my business online and in person. Because that's when I started to get back into teaching my Strong First courses, and I revamped the curriculum for my workshop, I'm Not Afraid to Lift. And by the end of 2017, I was in a really good groove with work between Cirque du Soleil, between my small online training business, and between the workshops I was teaching. So then fast forward, I go through 2018, everything is cranking, everything's going well, I'm working for Cirque, I have my workshops going, I have a little bit of my online clientele, I'm doing that. But I'm still feeling like I'm running a hamster wheel. There's still a large part of me that wants to transition my business 100% online. I wanted to get out of training people in person. I wanted to get out of that. I have this entrepreneur bug that I need to own businesses and run businesses, and I need to have that freedom to be my own boss and not work for anyone else. That is something that is a huge part of me. So that was something in 2018. By the end of it, I was like, okay, now what? I have myself back. I've worked on myself. I've de-stressed. I'm not burnt out anymore. I'm in a good groove with these other jobs, these three jobs that I'm juggling, which was Cirque du Soleil. I had some in-person clients in my garage that I was training, and then also my online training business and then workshop. So it was maybe almost four, maybe it was like 3.5 jobs. So at the end of 2018, that's when I felt like, okay, I'm ready. I'm ready to put forth the effort and transition my business 100% online. I'm ready to do this. So I signed up for a group coaching program with a coach at the end of 2018. And I signed up at the last day that this coach was offering the discount for the program that this coach was offering. The last day, it was like the 11th hour, right? We all do that, right? We sign up at the last minute because we're deliberating, right? And my deliberation was, gosh, am I gonna have time to show up for this program and do the work for the program? I don't know, because I'm juggling all these other jobs, but I know that I need to take the step to do this, because if I don't, then I'm never going to achieve my goal of transitioning my business 100% online. So I signed up, I pulled the trigger, and then I just figured out, I was petrified. I don't know, am I gonna waste some money? Because I just signed up for this and I don't know if I'm going to be able to put forth the time commitment to do it. But my thought was, I committed to it financially, I'm going to figure it out. And that's what I did. So through that group coaching program, what I did, unfortunately, I wasn't able to participate on the weekly group calls, but that's okay, because they were recorded. And how I managed that is every single time I was driving to my job at Cirque du Soleil and back, I would listen to the recording of the calls. And then every single week we had homework, I would listen to the homework in the car as well. I would do that, and then when I come home from Cirque, I'd be listening to calls and homework and have it here while I was making dinner and things like that. So that's how I manage it. I multitasked. And then as my online business started to grow in 2019, when I launched my one-on-one offer, because I revamped my one-on-one offering and I launched a new one-on-one offering in the beginning of 2019, when that happened and I started to get clients there, now that was really scary for me for two reasons. One, when I put that offer together and I launched it, and it was an offer that incorporated nutrition and strength training and mindset. At that time, I only had strength training. So this was a completely new offer that offered everything. And the reason why it was scary is when I put it out there, it was a higher ticket than I had ever offered before. So I was scared, are people going to want to pay this money? Am I charging too much? Am I charging too little for my worth, right? Or am I charging too much for people to even pay for it? So that was one fear. Another fear was, what if no one applies? What if I don't get any clients? Another fear was, what if I'm not capable? What if I think I'm capable of doing all this, you know, learning and everything that I need to do and all the pieces for my online business, but then when I actually start to take action, what if I'm not capable of doing it? What if I'm not good enough? So I had all these fears going through my mind and my body as I was launching this one-on-one offer. But I just did it. There's a three-step process that I like to acknowledge that happens when you get scared, when you have these fears. Number one, you have to feel the feeling. You just have to feel it. We're humans. We have to feel the feeling. After you feel the feeling, you need to acknowledge the feeling out loud, write it down, share it with a friend, share it with your significant other, do it all those ways. You have to acknowledge it, because by acknowledging it, you own it. And when you own it, that's when you know, okay, I'm recognizing it and now I can do something about it. The third step after you recognize it and after you own it is to take action. Just do the work, just take the action. Because even if you still have that fear in the pit of your stomach, you still have those butterflies, if you're taking action, you're solving the problem. And those butterflies, they diminish, they get less and less and less and less. So that's what I did at that time, is I felt the feeling, I acknowledged it, and then I just took action. I launched the offer, and then people applied, and it was amazing. And I did the work, I took the action. So when people applied, I took in the clients, and I was able to close my clients and all of that. And there was another fear that came up as this was all happening. Oh my gosh, how am I gonna balance all this? How am I gonna balance my online clients, my new online clients that are coming in, my existing online business, my job at Cirque, my in-person clients in my garage, and scheduling my workshops? Holy shit. How am I gonna do all this? Well, typically when you are making that transition, there is a period of time where you're juggling a lot of things and you are working overtime. So what I would do when on the days that I would go to Cirque is I would go to Cirque, I would come home, and if I had to listen to any calls or anything like that for my group coaching program, I would make sure to do it in the car so that when I came home after I ate dinner, and I have a dog, so I had to take my dog for a walk and feed my dog and all that too when I came home at 7:30 at night. And then I would also do any one-on-one client work or any social media work that I had to do for my online business. And I would do that until like 10:30 at night. And that was going on for a few months until I was able to let go of some things. So then I launched the offer, that new offer, in February 2019. And then by March 2019, I was able, 6 weeks later, not even that, it wasn't even that much longer because the offer had taken off and it was successful, I was able to let go of my job at Cirque. And that was a whole other series of fears when I did that. I let go of my job at Cirque, and I remember from the last, after I left on that last day, that same night, I came home from work that night after having my last day at Cirque, and my husband, we were gonna have dinner. I was just obsessing. I was agonizing and obsessing. Oh my gosh, should I do the right thing? Oh my gosh, what if I have no clients? What if all the clients disappear? I had all these fears about it. I don't know if I made the right decision. I don't know. I felt anxious. I felt doubtful. I felt fearful. It was just complete uncertainty for me. So again, I went through that three-step process. I recognized my feelings. I felt the feeling, and then I recognized the feeling, I owned it, and then I just did the work. So after that day that I came, my last day at Cirque, I came home, I had all those feelings, I spoke to my husband about it, I just felt everything I needed to feel, I let my brain overanalyze absolutely everything. The next morning, I woke up, and I just got to work, and I took action. And I just kept marketing my business and I kept servicing my existing clients. I just put the work in. And then within another about 10 days time from that day that I left Cirque, I had another 5 new clients. So you just have to make sure you recognize those feelings. You feel the feeling, you recognize it, and then you take action. And there's a lot more to the story. I'll tell another story, but that's all that we have time for today. I'll go back in time and tell you about previous times. There were 3 other times in my career as a fitness professional that I've had very similar fears when I've made transitions. One, when I left my office job to work in the fitness industry full time. 2, when I left the commercial gym to open my gym with my husband. 3, when we shut down our gym to move out to Las Vegas. So there were 3 other times that I had these fears, that I had these situations that I had to figure out how to manage this doubt, this anxiety, this worry, this fear, all of that. But everything turned out okay. Because as long as you are taking action, the problem will solve itself. So I hope that's some good advice and a nice story that helps you to kick off your Monday here and kick off your week. And I'll be back on to share more about my story in terms of how I transitioned my business 100% online. I'll see y'all soon.